and fans to different levels of anticipation. Every November, the excitement starts to build. First steps of a journey that captivates all who watch. And already there are signs that this could be a season that is truly something special. Tonight in St. John, New Brunswick, champions take flight. Alexei Yagudin begins his second season as world's number one. Like fellow Russians, pairs champions Berezhnaya and Sigurlitsi, establishing a standard all their own. The glint is back in the eye of Michelle Kwan, trying to regain her world crown. Canadian eyes will be watching as always. Dreams finally could be realized for Wing and Low. Their goal this year, to make the world team. Christy and Chris are back, newlyweds, champions. Tonight, the skating season begins in Canada. It's a rivalry that dates back to the beginning of the decade, when they were just teenagers and soon became their country's best. Elvis and Todd, Stoiko and Eldridge, so many times on the podium, so many times head to head. A little older now, a lot wiser, and tonight continuing their rivalry for the ages. Head to head, once again, at the Sun Life Skate Canada International. Canada's Figure Skating Network welcomes you to the banks of the Atlantic Ocean. St. John, New Brunswick, the home of the 1999 Sun Life Skate Canada International. Getting ready for this week's competition, some of the best skaters in the world assembled for the first skating competition here in Canada this season. Inside Harbour Station in St. John, New Brunswick, welcome everyone to the 1999 Sun Life Skate Canada International. 4 days of coverage beginning right here tonight on CTV. And greetings everyone, I'm Rod Black, and it's back. Yep, the figure skating season is upon us, and your Figure Skating Network will carry you through the Grand Prix Series, the Canadian Championships, all the way to the World Championships to be held in Nice, France in the spring. But before we get there, we have a lot of programs to be laid down. And tonight, Elvis Stoiko will try to lay down his second short program of the season. Actually, the season began last week at Skate America in Colorado Springs. Here is the Canadian champion, Stoiko, in his free skate quadruple jump in combination. He finished fourth after the short program. He ended up in third place overall last week. The champion was the world champion, two-time world champion, Alexei Yagudin of Russia. What a start for him to the new season. But the story last week for American men's skating, and maybe men's skating overall, Elvis Stoiko, the man who pushed the envelope so far in skating, added all of these quadruple jumps, watched as Timothy Gabel became the first man ever to land three quads in one performance. A quad sal, quad toes, and Tim Gabel finished second last week at Colorado Springs. The story for Canada, Jamie Saleh and David Peltier captured the pairs competition. They finished second in Canada a year ago, this bright new team. They did not go to the World Championships because of a sore back. No problem with the back last week. What a start to the new season. Jamie and David captured the Skate America competition, and they spoke with Debbie Wilkes afterwards.
They're both overwhelmed right now.
Well, I'll tell you something. I'm a sucker for romance, sentimental romance.
We felt absolutely fantastic out there today, and I think that both of us stepped on the ice the same as yesterday. And once again, when I grabbed his hand, I just knew it, and our coach said the same thing when, after I think we first started with the triple toes side by side and we nailed them. I really relaxed and just let it happen.
Well, that was something else. Debbie Wilkes is here with us to call the pairs competition. We welcome back Tracy Wilson to our coverage this year. By the way, Skate America will be shown on CTV Sportsnet next week. Before we get to tonight, I want to go back to last season as a reference point. When last we left you at the World Championships, toes were tapping in Helsinki, a judging controversy.
Two judges communicating during the event. They have been suspended. It sent a message out to the other judges. And what we saw at Skate America was some of the best judging. Generally, across the board, the judges were judging what they saw on the ice. And they can't do more than that.
Earlier today, practice session here was packed because of Elvis Stoiko. Everybody wants to know, how is Elvis doing? It appears he's injury-free right now.
Injury-free for the first time in a long time. He's not holding back. He's getting incredible lift on some of his jumps, including the triple axel, explosive footwork. But he is still building, and he's going to have his hands full with a strong men's field, including two other world champions, Todd Eldridge of the United States, and the man to beat, the current world champion, Alexei Yagudin of Russia.
And we could also see some quadruple jumps tonight. Elvis Stoiko will skate last. Tracy will be by with the men's later. First up, the pairs competition. Elena Berezhnaya, Anton Sigurlitsy of Russia, Debbie, are the defending world champions. They're here, but they had a tough time last week in Colorado Springs.
I was there at Skate America in Colorado Springs when Jamie Soleil and David Peltier just romped over the field, including the world champions. So although Jamie and David are not here, their next assignment is next week at Nations Cup in Germany. Elena and Anton are really suffering from a little bit of nerves. They will be chased by three Canadian pairs led by Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz, our Canadian champion.
Who are recently married, by the way. There has been lots of noise already this season, and expect more noise over the next 4 days here in St. John. Now, before we get things started, let's go downstairs to our ringside reporter. Here's Rob Faltz.
The competitive season is underway, and a lot of attention has been focused on the change of venue for Elvis Stoiko. Elvis has decided to take more coaching matters in his own hands, and to that end has moved from Mariposa to Philadelphia to train. He has a little more time to be just plain old Elvis and not Elvis Stoiko, skating superstar. He says it was simply time for a change.
Well, the biggest thing for me was the atmosphere at the rink. I needed a change. It was the same for so long. Last number of years, I was thinking about it, but I just sort of continued on. Sort of the loyalty to Doug and what he's done for me. But I had to really think about myself. It's a selfish thing to do, but in a sport, you have to, because in essence, it's about the athlete. And you got to do what's right for you. And Doug understood that. And seeing him here and talking, it's been great. Talk about boats and the things we talked about before. And our friendship is there. And that's the type of person that Doug is and the type of person that I am. That, you know, business is business and what we need to do for ourselves. But our friendship doesn't change. And what we've done in the past doesn't change. And that's a big thing.
For Canadian skate fans, this is the first time they will see Elvis Stoiko compete without Doug Lee standing by the boards. But Doug is here in St. John as he coaches Takeshi Honda of Japan. We've got an update for you on Paul Benabos of the United States. He was injured in a training accident in Delaware with his partner Laura Handy in late September. He hit his head on the ice, fracturing his skull, and in fact lapsed into a coma. We can tell you that he is out of the coma right now. He is showing some motor skills and is responding to outside stimuli. So for the 21-year-old right now, all we can say is the news is encouraging. But of course, for everybody in the skating community, their hopes and prayers are with Paul Benabos. Let's join Rod and Tracy.
And alongside in the booth, Debbie Wilkes for the pairs program here at Sun Life Skate Canada International. And here is a pair that really captured the imagination last year of Canadian skating fans. They finished third at the Nationals, but because of the injury to Salley and Pelletier, they went to the Worlds and finished 13th.
About 2 minutes and 40 seconds for 8 required elements.
Valerie Sorette and Jean-Sébastien Fecteau of Canada.
Their first element, a relatively easy twist, only a double is allowed.
Thank you.
side-by-side triple toes. Most of the pair skaters consider that element the toughest of the eight. They've been doing well on it all week. Not so tonight. Right into the throw triple salchow. That's an element that they always have in their pocket, and they needed that.
Went to the World Championships a few months ago. Didn't really expect to get to Finland, but they got there and they did well. And now they want to get their skating season off on the right foot. Sarette and Fecteau here in New Brunswick. Back at Harbor Station, waiting for the marks for Valerie Sarette and Jean-Sébastien Fecteau. A bluesy short program it was.
A real departure for them. Unfortunately, the side-by-side triple toes were not a good element for them. If one skater falls, it's a mandatory deduction of 0.3. You'll see that on the first mark. But here, the throw was a beauty. The throw triple salchow, nice and tight in the air. I have not seen Valerie miss that landing every practice. Solid, strong.
How much do you think, as you see them alongside Coach Richard Gauthier, getting a chance to go to the World Championships when they didn't expect to go, help this team along their path towards what could be even better days ahead?
Well, in dreaming their dream, I think they felt that it was an opportunity of a lifetime. They grew from it. They came to understand just how important it was to compare yourselves against the best in the world.
Marks are a little low, bringing out some boo birds here in St. John, New Brunswick. For Sarette and Fecteau, but the marks, particularly the technical marks, a result of the fall.
Every skater knows that short program. You've got to lay those eight down.
Our next competitors, representing the United States, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman.
They were second in the U.S. last season and finished ninth at the Worlds. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman.
This is their second season together. They worked very hard over the summer, now being coached by Tamara Moskvina. They worked hard to try to become a real partnership. Skating to music from The Truman Show. They are opening with side-by-side triple toes. Again, trouble. Beautiful twist. The required element is a Lutz twist, named because it is based on the individual Lutz jump, determined by the woman's entry. Very nice spin. Unison is perfect. And that unison is made more difficult by virtue of changes of position and the change of foot. Original hip lift. And the Moxvina trademark spin, originally invented by former Olympic champion Natalia Mishkochunik and Artur Dimitriev.
Who they train with Tamara Moxvina. They also are training with the world champions, Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sigurlitsy.
They say it has been a wonderful experience for them. And you can see the styles are starting to mesh.
Speaking of those world champions, Berezhnaya and Sigurlitsy will skate next at the 99 Sun Life Skate Canada International. Live Skate Canada International. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman of the United States will also, like the skaters before them, suffer some deductions from elements.
Yeah, those jumps, they get so spooky. The skaters get so nerved up about them. Now, Kyoko bailed and only did a double toe. John had more problem. A variety of deductions mandatory in that case. John also had a slight slip in the footwork, but the forward inside death spiral was lovely. Long, the positions are beautiful. Her arch is positively gorgeous. It's held for a very long period of time, and he is in a required pivot position with that left toe backed into the ice. A beautiful element for this pair. Here's a look at the hip lift. She reverses leg position in the air. It gets a little bit sloppy, kind of floppy actually, but the takeoff was good, and then the landing was fabulous. Very interesting. Also increases the difficulty. The pair spin at the very end had some great position, some unusual movement, but they lost a little bit of balance there just as they approached the very end of the program.
The marks for
Kyoko knows what it's like to be a winner. She was a former champion along with partner Jason Dungeon before forming this partnership. And perhaps they're thinking, you know, the Russians have been so strong for so many years. If we can't beat them, let's join them, then try to beat them.
Maybe a good plan. Lot to learn there.
And they currently are the leaders here. Ina and Zimmerman of the United States.
5-3, 5-2.
Marks for presentation better.
5-6, 5-4, 5-4, 5-4.
But a number of teams is still to skate.
Thank you.
And the team everybody's watching, and last week was watching, and probably disappointed with as well, a slow start to the new season for these two, Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sigurlitsy, the two-time world champions from Russia.
It was a complete puzzle to everyone what happened. Now, a lot of the talk at Colorado Springs was how the skaters felt it was much too early in the season to be having to perform at altitude. Everybody was gasping for air, most of all, Elena and Anton. I don't get the music. To me, it does not make an attractive program for this elegant couple. I love march music, but look at the twist. The best one in the competition. Huge. For their side-by-side triples.
Struggles continue.
control. If you try really hard listening at home, you may hear one of the partners giving directions for when to change and when to exit during those spins. That's a fabulous entry into that lift, but it just collapsed. Judges consider that lift as an omission, it could be up to a 0.5 deduction.
And another slip up.
This is like Skate America all over again.
It is quite obvious. These world champions are not skating like it right now.
Yikes.
Consolation being that it's early in the season, but you do not want to send signals to the rest of the world that you are vulnerable.
It's not good to be beaten.
Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sigurlidze, and they will also be heavily deducted.
Oh, big time. And the problem is they are not just losing to better teams. They are losing.
Period.
They were third at Skate America, which I thought was kind of a gift. And I don't think this music suits their talent. They are softer. The way this twist soars, it has that lightness and airiness to it. They have an elegance, a gentleness to their skating that I just don't think matches the music. And the skaters are inspired by music. Here, look at the triple toes. Both partners in big trouble.
Somewhat harsh music for their subtle and soft touches.
I agree. However, this throw was exquisite. They've been working on throw quad salchows here, coming very, very close to landing them. And you know what I like about their throw? Anton doesn't sit back and wait for her to land. He carries through. Now here, what in the world happened in the lift? She started to go up nicely, then she seemed to be carried too far forward on the lift, a very delicate point of balance for a pair skater. It just crumbled. And then another accident just as they stepped into the pair spin at the end.
They had a total of four errors in the program. If my Russian was better, I could have probably understand what Anton was saying in the kiss and cry area, but it's obvious that this team has a lot of work to do.
Well, they were his faults. They were not Elena's faults from the looks of things. Elena did make the fall in the side-by-side, but the pair elements were definitely Anton's problem.
And you can't blame altitude this week.
No. We had an email from someone here in New Brunswick who was talking about the altitude problem here, that everybody should be fine because we're probably minus 10 feet here in Harbor Station, which is below sea level.
Well, this team has won practically everything there is to win over the last couple of years. If you go back to the World Championships in Finland, arguably they could have finished second due to the judging controversy, the
That's
two
right.
judges that were eventually suspended, the Chinese pair potentially
hot.
Could have won gold at that time.
That's right. And I'm sure that all of those little failures have played on this pair's psyche. Plus, their coach, Tamara Moskvina, has said that moving to the States to train has created a whole bunch of temptations that they would never have had in Russia. And she's trying to back off and let them take more responsibility for their training. And she says there is a Russian saying, falling and standing up, you grow.
Four nine.
Well, they
the marks for presentation.
We'll have to grow some now. but the presentation marks elevate them.
5-3.
They are currently
five,
the
seven,
leaders, and
five, four,
you have to
five,
wonder
six,
about that, particularly
five, seven,
Ina and Zimmerman,
five,
who
six,
had some mistakes,
five,
but certainly
six,
not as
five,
many
six,
as Berezhnaya and Sigurlitsi.
Thank you.
And, you know, I think that even the second mark, how can you have four mistakes in a 2 minute and 40 second program and give the skaters 5.7? Please.
It is an athletic event. You also have to do all of the elements. They didn't. They shouldn't be first. Simple. So the door is open now for Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz. The Canadian champions are next on CTV. Brunswick. And on the ice, the two-time champions of Canada finished sixth at the World Championships in Finland, then got married. And here another season begins for Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz.
Their daughter Tristan is watching on TV at home.
The new short program for Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz. A spill on the side-by-side triples, but then again, everybody has had a spill tonight. This should be better than Berezhnaya and Sigurlitsi. If it's not, there should be an inquiry.
I'm with you.
The marks for the Canadian champions when we come back. Competition is a married couple, by the way, as well. And we'll get their marks in a moment. Let's join Rob Falls backstage.
Rod, things might not be right now in Berezhnaya and Sigurlitsi's camp immediately after their short program. Take a look at the conversation the two of them were having. In fact, Elena actually went into the ladies' locker room to get away from Anton. Anton came off the ice, took off his uniform top, threw it into the trash can, and then quickly came out to retrieve it. So right now, let's say they're big time on the disgruntled side.
Well, Robbie, if you remember last year in Kamloops at Skate Canada, this happens in pair skating. As a former pair skater, I don't think you always got along with your partner. Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz a year ago also had a much publicized spat.
Yes, they did. You get so committed to doing the best that you can, and you become so disappointed and so frustrated when accidents happen. They had problems with the side-by-side jumps, but the spins were beautiful. Perfectly matched positions, the timing and rhythm, speed of rotation, everything right on.
Do you know, after that dispute that they had last year, that argument, which was on television, by the way, I think they were a little embarrassed by it, but you know what? They also used that as fuel, and I think that helped them retain their Canadian championship.
The marks, they did learn from it. They were very embarrassed, I think, Rod, and they talked about it to us after.
Look at the marks for required elements. They should be marked down, but you know something? I still don't agree that they should be marked lower than Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsi, who had four errors. Presentation marks are lower than Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsi, which will hold them down. The ordinals are pretty split, but can you believe it? They're second. Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsi.
What Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsi did do was exquisite. Better than some of the elements of Chrissy and Chris. However,
but riddled with errors.
Absolutely.
Our next competitors, representing Canada, Jacinthe Lariviere and Lenny Postino.
Well, here is the third Canadian pair of the evening, Jacinthe Lariviere and Lenny Postino. Good chance here to get some international experience as they also embark on the new season. They were seventh at the Junior Worlds of 1999.
You'll probably recognize this music as being from the Mission soundtrack. With Jennifer Robinson's old music, and they pleaded with Jen's coach, Michelle Lee, please let us use it. Let's see if it's good for them. Side by side. Closest one tonight. Big speed and huge ice coverage on that twist. Problems on the landing of the throw triple loop. So much of the throw jump success depends on how the man pitches the woman into the air. Section is one of the required elements. The judge is looking for ice coverage, speed, and difficulty of steps. But I think the forward inside death spiral is their very best element. Look at that beautifully wide arc on the entry. Justin is down in death spiral position very quickly. Spin. This is very weird.
It's been one of those nights, and maybe we can attribute it to the early season jitters or rust, maybe also to the lack of experience for these two, but they're going to use this to help buoy them along their second season as seniors into their third. Lariviere and Faustino. Lena Bereshnaya and Anton Sigurlitsi, the leaders, questionable leaders, leaving right now and leaving through opposite exits. as Anton decides to join Elena, but I'm still a little baffled. Four missed elements compared to one missed element for Sargent and Wirtz. I know their presentation is better, or appears to be better.
The general quality of skating is superior, but I concede your point.
You can't keep that. Otherwise, why do the elements? Just come out and skate without doing them all and then get great presentation marks.
It's hard for other pairs on the roster who do a better job. Our third Canadian team, Justin LaRivière and Lenny Faustino, had some problems with the throw, but the death spiral was absolutely the best in the competition. I love the way it goes down so quickly. It takes forever to hit the pivot, and it lasts forever. Sign of a fabulous element. However, they moved on to the pair spin at the end of the program, which would normally be a very easy element for most of the teams. They just slightly got off balance, tripped and fell. Those kinds of things are hard to pick up and recover from.
Jacinth is 18 from Princeville, Quebec, and Lenny is 20 from outside of Toronto and Woodbridge. They train in Mariposa.
3-9.
Required elements marks will be low. Presentation marks will be higher. This is really their first major international competition.
Now, you know, I'm getting mad with you too, Rod, because look at the marks here, 3.6. That's embarrassing to a team when Bereznai and Sigurlitsi were not deducted.
5-0.
We're not deducted. Absolutely, we're not deducted. And yes, they're world champions, but you still have to go out and skate. It doesn't matter who you are.
Thank you.
This is not a sport based on merit. It shouldn't be.
I bet you there'll be some clucking about this.
Our final pairs competitors this evening, representing China, Qian Peng and Jian Tang.
Qian Peng and Jian Tang, our final pairs team of the evening in the short program. Bereznai and Sigurlitsi are first. Sargent and Wirtz are second.
Interestingly, Rod, Sargent and Wirtz have a first place ordinal. Guess who from? The Russian judge. Good one. Fair amount of training in the U.S. Their programs have been choreographed this year by Leanne Miller. They're starting with the throw. That one is southpaw. Let's see if they get the triple toe. Oh my goodness! At the same time.
If they continue this, they should be on top.
Twist. It's in lateral position, horizontal to the ice. That position in the air is optional for the skaters. Hip lift, so far the only less than wonderful element in the program. Oh.
Just when we thought we might have a clean skate.
These are such unusual errors that are happening to these pairs. It almost makes me feel like there's something soggy in the ice. I'm looking out at it. It is quite frosty on top. It's almost as if the skaters' edges are being grabbed. The bodies are moving, but the edges are getting stuck.
Maybe that could be the case. But boy,
especially in things like the pair spin. You never see this happen.
No. Despite that little glitch at the end, it's obvious that China is fast becoming a pair's power in the skating world. This is the second-ranked team in China. Of course, Zhuya Shen and Hongbo Zhao could be on their way.
With them.
Could be on their way to world title status eventually. And this team, by training with them, are obviously gaining some of their expertise in the wake.
Well, let's have a look at the one side-by-side triple toe element from the pairs that actually worked. Very fast on the setup. Not only did it work, it was picture perfect. Here's the spin, though. What in the world happened here? She went to hit her toe pick. It completely slipped on her as if the ice chipped away. Hitting that camel spin, the skater will hit up onto the toe pick for just a fraction of a second, which is the moment when the spin really starts to rotate. That's when the camel position, the spiral position, actually takes effect. The very end of the performance, this is a team that we first saw at Four Continents last year in Halifax. She has grown immensely. Another problem for pair skaters.
Well, an interesting night. Certainly not a clinic on pair skating. Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsy, the leaders. And you wonder if Hong and Tung can still find a way to certainly elevate their names up amongst Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsy and Sargent and Wirtz.
They got to be up there.
You would have to think, but then again, it's kind of puzzling still why Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsy are up there. But in the judges' defense, it has not been a night where you can match one against one. You're matching mistake against mistake.
It's unfortunate because every skater and, of course, every judge would like to be able to place their marks based on the best skating from the best skaters. And when you have a night like this, you mentioned earlier, it's like nobody wants to win it.
For required elements.
Well, required elements marks again docked heavily. Docked heavily.
4-9, 5-0.
But at least they're up into the fives.
5-2, 4-8.
But had they stayed on their feet, you would think they would be in first place, but they're not going to be. The presentation marks are lower. They will be in third place heading into the free skate. Sargent and Wirtz are second.
Interestingly here, Rob, all the top four teams, the top five teams have first place votes. So it's going to be anybody's competition.
But Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsy, the world champions, despite their problems, despite their troubles here in St. John tonight, the leaders, Sargent and Wirtz, they had some trouble too there in second place. Valerie Sorette and Jean-Sebastien Fecteau currently in sixth. And still ahead, we have the men's short program. That's still to come later tonight, but here's Rob Falls with Chris and Christy.
Well, one missed element, you stand in second place. Is this just a situation where you just say, okay, fine, we'll get it back in the long program?
Exactly. We had a good time up there, and we did make mistakes, so, I mean, it happens. And tomorrow we're going to get them in the long because we have a great long.
Tell me the one problem tonight.
Well, I think it's the problem a lot of people have. Sometimes when you jump in, you feel like you're going to miss. So, I mean, I had to put my hand down because I was going to jerk off my edge like that. And Christy, I think she fell down because she just, well, I don't know what she did because, no.
I just fell down.
Yeah. I mean, we're relaxed. We're happy. It's a new attitude that we have, and we just have to take it easy because mentally we're going to kill ourselves if we get too stressed.
Good luck in the free.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I think that Bereshnaya and Sigurlitsy are really feeling the pressure of being world champions, and they are simply not making the mark. So any one of those top five teams can really push on them.
I know it's a broken record sometimes, and you look at the judging and you look at the marks, and they're certainly, they have the job and we don't have the job. It's easy for us to sit here and criticize, but What happened to Berezhnya and Sigurlitsy, and how in the world were they still able to get the marks they did to stay in first place?
Well, let's start off by saying that no skater goes out purposely to make mistakes. It's one of those things that happens. Some skaters recover more quickly during a performance when they've made a mistake. A lot of skaters say, let's move on from here. For them, I think that they are still reeling from the terrible defeat they felt last weekend at Skate America. And there's some, you know, there's some real power struggles going on within that pair. We're not really privy to what exactly is going on, but you see it on the ice. You see that they are fighting. That does not work out well when you're under pressure.
Did they get a gift tonight?
Yeah.
When we come back, we'll have the men's short program. Tracy Wilson will be by. Thanks, Deb. We'll see you tomorrow. Elvis Stoiko, straight up. Last to skate at the 99 Sun Life Skate Canada International. To the top of the world in Edmonton, Todd Eldridge. He's the human boomerang. He just keeps coming back. He has maintained his eligibility. And even though we kind of said Todd was going on to the pro level a few competitions ago, he's still skating, and he will be in the field tonight for the short program. Here is who you will see: Ben Ferreira of Canada, Dmitry Dimitrenko of Ukraine, Alexei Yagudin. Now, I know we've been saying Yagudin over the last couple of years. As a matter of fact, Alexei said his name was Yagudin, and this year, maybe because he's living in the United States now, he says, call me whatever you want, but we'll call him Yagudin. Takeshi Honda training in Barrie and Mariposa. And there is Alexei and Elvis Stoiko, who has left the Mariposa Club in Barrie. He is now skating in Philadelphia with coach Uschi Kessler. Elvis has a new short program, a new free skate this year, and he says he is also healthy. Elvis will skate last tonight. And right out of the starting gate, first skater, not always the best position to skate in. Here
our
is
first competitor,
Edmonton's Ben
Canada,
Ferreira.
Ben Ferreira.
A major competition for Ben to be attending. He only has two this year, this one and Canadian. This is about skating for his future. Making a name for himself, earning a reputation at this competition. This jump will go a long way to helping him. Triple axel, yes. Triple axel, double toe. There's one of the required elements, the combination. Next element, triple lutz. Conviction this year. His footwork sequence working right from the feet all the way up, connecting with the audience. He has one last jump planned. Can only be a double axel. Thank you.
think they fixed the ice.
Ben Ferreira, I have watched him skate as many Canadian skate fans have over the last few years, from a junior to the senior ranks, and so much potential. And I think this is probably the best I have ever seen him skate.
He had to do it here, Rod. He has to start getting that reputation with these international judges. I think he'd like to get a spot on that world team this year for Canada. He's worked hard, and it's nice to see it's paid off for him.
Fifth last year at the Nationals. His marks upcoming here at the Sun Life Skate Canada International. 20-year-old Ben Ferreira from Edmonton, Alberta, and the Royal Glenora Club. Still to skate, Todd Eldridge. And moments ago, Rob Falls caught up with the former world champion.
Todd, you have this opportunity now to explain to us exactly how many of the Grand Prix events you're competing in.
One. No, it's for me to keep my eligibility, I have to do one of them this year. Mostly, only reason I have to only do one is because I'm not a seated skater from the previous year. So that was the big thing with me. Basically, I only had to do one.
So you're going to do that to retain your eligibility for the World Championships, but you're not skating in your own nationals?
Right, right. I'm not. I'm just basically keeping my eligibility, and that's what I have to do to keep it for this year. And, you know, I'm not going to compete the nationals or the World Championships this year, but, you know, as far as my skating goes, and we'll see what happens next year and how I feel.
How difficult a decision was that for you?
Not at all. No, this year actually, it was an easy decision to make, just to kind of take it easy again and really get my skating, I think, back in better shape than it has been for a little while. So, you know, and it's back hopefully in good enough shape for this event.
Good luck to you.
Thanks.
And really a decision also based on the fact he can be eligible for Pro-Am competitions, where he gets to skate up against some of his old rivals as well.
And he's had good success in those competitions. In fact, recently at the Masters, he defeated Alexei Yagudin in both the short and long program to win the competition.
So Ben Ferreira is still waiting for his marks. Let's take a look at the combination, the triple axel off the top.
I love the way he gets down there, vaults up into the air. Look at the height, very good height. Picks in and does a double. If he had more speed, he'd be able to do a triple on the end, which is allowed and obviously more difficult. This is an area where I think Ben can improve on his line, on stretching a little bit more, getting lower in the sit spin, getting that free leg out straighter. And you'll see Todd Eldridge, who will be coming up. He does it perfectly. But I think for Ben, he has accomplished what he set out to do here, a job well done.
I don't know if anybody in the world can spin like Todd Eldridge, though. He is one of the very best. And Ben starts off the men's short program with a very strong performance. 4-7, a little low perhaps from the American judge, but pretty good marks for required elements. And presentation should be a little bit better. And I think Ben has to be really happy with himself tonight.
This is a program he can build on.
5-1. There are the marks. So the marks will be watching the standard set by the young Canadian Ben Ferreira. 5-2, 5-1. And coming up, two-time world champion, trying to make it three on the road to another Worlds, Alexei Yagudin at Sun Life Skate Canada International. He keeps coming back, and that's good news for skating. Still eligible. Todd Eldridge from Chatham, Massachusetts. First world championships back in 1990. Tracy Wilson in Halifax, where he finished fifth.
But most skaters agree the pressure that you face in those is very different from the pressure here. Opening with his combination, triple lutz, triple toe planned. There's a triple lutz, triple toe. defender not to try the quad, but here's his triple axel. Great height. This is what he does better than anybody in the world. Look at the sit position. Changes to a back sit. Three legs straight out, low to the ice. Degree of difficulty because every one of his jumps is a triple. He has four in all. Here's the fourth and his most difficult for him, triple loop. Just lands it, leaning in the air. Feet like a cat.
Think about retiring.
I think he likes the pressure. Brings out the best in him.
Todd Eldridge of the United States. 9 years ago in Halifax, his first world championships. Finished fifth overall. Four places back of him was a young Elvis Stoiko. That was their first Worlds together. And who would have thought near the end of the decade they'd still be going head-to-head. Elvis still ahead. Todd's marks when we come back. To the obvious, Elvis Stoiko, Elvis and Eldridge, they have both owned men's skating in their countries. Todd, a five-time national champion. Elvis, a five-time national champion. Todd wins a world championship. Elvis wins three. Elvis has a couple of Olympic medals. Todd has none.
And that's one of the reasons he's keeping his options open. Here's a look at his triple lutz. Lands it, reaches in. Finished with a triple toe loop. Again, I said he's doing four triples in his program so he can try and compete with the quad. But watch this axel. Look at the distance. Height and distance and the speed coming out. Beautiful technique on that. In fact, he had great speed throughout. This is the jump that gives him trouble. Trouble in practice. Triple loop. Watch how he goes up, and he doesn't have anywhere near the height of the other jumps. He's leaning. But that's experience for you, Rod. He found a way to save that jump.
The only thing that separates the two of them, besides a border, 6 months, Todd is 28. Elvis will be turning 28 in the year 2000. The quad, the quadruple
Mark
jump. Todd has no quad.
Eldridge for required element.
He's going to need it if he wants to be a contender at the Olympics. But boy, nice set of marks here. And you can see X with a quad. The difference in these marks would come up considerably. I personally, though, his spins are so beautiful. The way he covers the ice, I like the package, the whole package, not just the quad.
Elvis still ahead. Two great competitors, and the best comparison between the two of them, they're two very classy guys, both Todd Eldridge and Elvis Stoiko. So Elvis, still to skate.
Our next competitor from Ukraine.
Last tonight, Todd Eldridge is the leader. And here is another one of their rivals, really, over the last few years, although he hasn't been able to get onto the podium on the world stage. Here is Dmitry Dmytrenko of Ukraine.
Skating to Adagio by Albinoni, and he chose this as a tribute to his longtime choreographer, Yelena Gonichenko. She passed away last year, and this is one of her favorite pieces. triple axel, triple toe. Not enough speed to do the triple toe. Watch the 1 foot entrance into his triple lutz. 2 foot landing. It's approximately a 0.2 deduction for a touchdown.
Time competitor at the Skate Canada competitions. Dmitry Dmytrenko has always marched to his own beat. Finished 14th at the Olympics in Nagano, was 11th in the world in Finland a few months ago.
Program obviously heartfelt. I like the way he skated it. He does have a few deductions coming his way, though. If you compare him with Ben Ferraro of Canada, Dmitry had beautiful spins, nice line in his spin, very elegant. But he made some mistakes that Ben didn't.
Tried to make his way through the gate, finally did, and now awaits his marks. Let's take a look at Dmitry Dmytrenko.
Well, you see, he gets up here into the triple axel, nice height, but the toe pick digs in, and when you dig in your toe pick, you don't have speed. His body was leaning forward. He just was able to eke out a double toe. In a combination, they can do two triples, or they can do a triple-double. And here's a look at the Lutz. Watch when he comes down. He's got two-foot landing there. A slight touchdown is 0.1 to 0.2 deduction. Clear touchdown like that can go as high as a 0.3 deduction. Here's a look at one of his spins. I liked the uniqueness of this program. I thought his footwork on 1 foot, very difficult and also innovative.
Ukraine, of course, a long line of very good men skaters. Viktor Petrenko, Vyacheslav Zarogorodniak, who recently turned pro, Evgeny Pliuta, who won the national title in Ukraine this past season. Dmitry Dmytrenko has been around as long as Elvis and Todd Eldridge, and it's kind of funny, he's only won one national title back in 1993. It was the same year, however, he got his biggest win ever. It was the European Championships.
Huge win, 1993. This year, 11th at the world. He's just having trouble breaking through.
Judges making their marks, and here they are for required elements.
The marks
from
for Dmitry Dmytrenko for required elements
to 5.1.
And you can see the deductions. They come out of the first set of marks. Marks not as good as Ben Ferreira's of Canada.
So that's good news for Ben Ferreira when he can measure himself against an international competitor like Dmitry Dimitrenko, and then all of a sudden say, hey, I'm on top of you in the standings.
Dmitry Dimitrenko is ranked 11th in the world. It's good news for Ben.
Todd Eldridge is the leader. Next to skate, the two-time world champion. And then after him, last to skate will be the three-time world champion, trying to get back on top this season. Continuing, Todd Eldridge is the leader right now. Ben Ferreira of Canada is currently third. Elvis Stoico will skate last. Rod Black, Tracy Wilson, Debbie Wilkson, Rob Falls with you. The next four skaters have all planned quadruple jumps.
But this is the only skater who has successfully done it in a short program in competition.
Here he is, the defending world champion, two times, Alexei Yagudin.
You've heard of the Nutcracker. Well, this is the Nut Rocker. And this is the Quad Toe coming up.
Yes!
Now for the triple axel, triple toe loop. There's the axel. Wow.
Sweet.
Makes it look automatic.
Alexei Yagudin, the world champion. He has been so busy skating in a competition almost weekly, and he just keeps getting better.
Let's take a look as he picks in. Good height. Not as sharp and strong as I've seen him, but boy, that's a clean quad for a short program. Watch him pick in. Nice height. He says he does this for the future, that in order to be on the top of the podium at the Olympics, he's going to need a quad in both programs. I think that's upping now. I think he's going to need a couple quads in the long to win the way men are going. Look at the height on that triple axel. Enough height and enough speed coming out that he can then do the triple toe at the end. But, you know, quads and triples aside, look at this, and look at the height layout position of the death drop. Nice position on the back sit spin.
He has become such a polished performer, also skating in some professional slash amateur competitions. Recently, he finished second to Todd Eldridge at the Masters. But I'm amazed, since he started working with Tatiana Tarasova, it seems to show a different side of Alexei Yagudin that we didn't see in Minneapolis when he won his first Worlds.
You're right, and this is an excited reaction to his program. And here's Tatiana Tarasova. She coaches all the disciplines, including ice dance. That's where she became so well known, and she is able to draw the emotion out of her skaters.
And he's still only 19 years old. Alexei Yagudin.
5'7".
Wow.
5'8".
5'8".
5'7". 5'8".
Recently had a bout of indiscretions on the Champions on Ice Tour. In fact, was kicked off in the summer. Maybe just needed to rethink things. Got his focus back. And I'll tell you what, coming off a Skate America win last week, he's in good position to make it two in a row to start the new season. Unbelievable. And still ahead,
our next
Mr. Stoico,
representing China, Chengjian Li.
But among those who have followed the lead of Elvis Stoico on the quadruple jump is Chengjian Li of China.
And the quad is his most consistent jump. He nailed it every time he tried it in practice, but he did have difficulty with the triple. Content in this footwork sequence, but a little scratchy on the toe picks, which makes it a little bit slow. Judges counting the revolutions, must be 6 on each foot.
First look at Chengjian Li last season when he finished second at the Four Continents Championships. He has arrived, this young man from China. His marks in a moment. fear might be that China is suddenly becoming a power in figure skating.
Well, apparently they have 14 men who can do the quad, and I don't think anybody better than Sheng Zhang. Watch this, good speed going in. He picks up, keeps the rotation going. Look at how straight his back is when he lands. A lot of skaters pitch forward to try and save the landing. Let's take a look. He picks in, that vaults him up into the air. Nice, tight position with the feet. Look at that. And you can see he's got a good, strong edge coming out of the quad. Look at the flow still growing. This is what he had trouble with all week in practice. He was adjusting the arm, the rotation, everything. But here, you'd never know. This is a skater, obviously, who can rise to the occasion.
His countryman, Zheng Jin Guo, became the first man to land two quads in one competition a couple of years ago at the Worlds. Zheng Jin Guo went to the Worlds. Jing Jiang Li did not go to the World Championships in Helsinki, so that's going to be quite a battle brewing in China between those two men.
Here's a look at his coach. He knows he's done it as well as he can do it. I think as far as his artistry, though, similar to many of the Chinese skaters, that's the area. They've got the technique down, and now we're working and developing that. Didn't have quite the finesse and the polish of Yagudin, but all that will come.
Good friend of Liu Chen.
The marks for Cheng Jian Li for required elements.
The Chinese rise.
5-7.
In skating. 5-6.
Great mark.
5-7. 5-7. 5-5.
Required elements marks. Alexei Yagudin, remember, the leader. I don't think his marks will touch him, but he could squeeze into second. He does.
5-5.
With the presentation marks. 5-1 from the American judge, all the way to 5-8 from the Ukrainian judge. So a wide range on presentation. But Cheng Cheng Li of China is second between Yagudin, the leader, and Todd Eldridge in third. And getting his last moment's instruction.
Our next competitor, representing Japan, Takeshi Honda.
From coach Doug Lee, Japan's Takeshi Honda, who trains in Barrie, Ontario at the Mariposa Club. He finished sixth at the 99 Worlds.
But we remember his big win at Four Continents when he defeated the Chinese skater Lee and also Elvis Stoiko. He has yet to land the quad in the short program. Takeshi is opening with his combination, triple axel, triple toe loop. Here it comes. Great height, beautiful triple toe. He attempted the quad in the short program at Worlds and fell. Here it comes.
Not quite there yet.
Jump, double axel. Ooh, just hung on to that. Commanding presence on the ice this year. Stronger back, good presentation.
can land the quad in competition in the long. Now he just has to get it into this short program.
Not tonight. But one of those young teenagers will be watching for years to come, Takeshi Honda. Really nice young man.
Sitting there with Coach Doug Lee, and let's take a look at his combination. Look at the height on that triple axel, straight up and down. Topic digs in a little bit on the landing, but he's able to get the height he needs to land a very nice triple toe loop on the end. Now, Doug was telling him he was happy with his attempted quad. He said direction was good, but the foot just slipped out underneath him, and you could see his ankle twist.
Skateboard Japan makes his home during the skating season, and Barry has become a big hockey fan as well. A Maple Leafs fan in Toronto, went to his first hockey game last week, had a great time, he said. Presentation marks.
Good presentation marks, and I think this is an area that Takeshi has really improved.
Currently ranked fourth. Yagudin is first. Lee is second. Eldridge third. One guy left. He's next. You're the man. And indeed in Canada, he still very much is.
Our final competitor this evening, representing Canada, Elvis Stoico.
He is the pioneer who took the quadruple jump, turned it into an art form, and now it is practically a required element. But he has never landed the quad in competition in the short program. Right now, tonight, he has to. Here's Elvis.
Elvis is opening with a triple axel, triple toe combination.
Yes! First time ever in the short program for Elvis.
Watch this footwork. It's explosive.
new short program to Cirque du Soleil, some new moves, a new season for Elvis Stoiko, and the same thing that he has done many, many times. He delivers. Can that short program beat the short program of Alexei Yagudin? We'll find out when we come back to St. John, New Brunswick. Climax to a fabulous night of men skating in the short program. Three quadruple jumps landed cleanly. We can almost call that, Tracy Wilson, the Stoiko rule, because Elvis was the guy who's taken this quad to a new level, and finally he lands one in the short program.
He started trying the quad in the short program last year at Skate America, but let's watch this triple axel. Look at the lift he gets. He's not hampered by an injury. He can skate free. He doesn't have to hold back and favor the groin injury that he had. There's nothing more frustrating for an athlete than not being able to just go for it. Here's a look at the quad. Gets good height, clean landing. Now, Elvis told me before the most important thing for him is to keep the rhythm here on the takeoff. Then once he picks in, he's got to climb to the top of the jump so he can get all the rotation. Tendency is you want to rush it. You want to pull it in before you get right to the very top of that jump.
You mentioned the groin injury. He also had a knee problem this summer and a broken collarbone that he had to rehab, but he looked good tonight.
And there's a moment of personal triumph for Elvis, and that's what it's all about for him. It's that personal challenge. He wants the best that he can give.
For the first time since he was a teenager, he comes to a rink and goes to a competition without Doug Lee beside him. His coach, Uschi Kessler. Tim Wood is also a consultant in this new team. He now trains down in Philadelphia, and there is the leader watching, Alexei Yagudin.
Will it be enough to overcome Yagudin? Yagudin had very strong, charismatic footwork sections.
And a quad.
And a quad as well. And you very, very close in my mind.
Well, the required elements, Mark.
Five nines
are there. It will be the presentation mark. Will it be enough to put him over the top, give him the lead heading to the free skate?
He has beaten Yagudin technically.
Marks for presentation.
Here come the presentation. 5.4 from the British judge who marks Elvis in third. I don't know about that one. I don't think there was anybody in this field tonight.
5.9, 5.8.
That British judge could have put Elvis two places behind, but Stoiko is second, heading to the free skate.
In first place from Russia,
three first place ordinals, the rest twos, and then a third, and there's Alexei Yagudin, who will be the leader heading to the free skate.
A close, well-fought competition.
Oh, outstanding. Outstanding skating here in St. John, New Brunswick. Alexei Yagudin, world champion, as he's sending a message early in this season. Elvis second. The three men who landed the clean quads, 1, 2, 3 in the short program. And Ben Ferreira, what a good competition so far for him, currently in seventh place. Now let's join Rob Faltz with Mr. Stoiko.
Elvis Stoiko, you keep raising the bar. Everybody catches up to you. You get the quad in the short program. What are your feelings right now knowing that you're in the pack?
It feels great. Come out. It was a tough position to skate in. Skating last in this event, everyone had skated pretty well, the top guys anyways. I knew that standing in the back, I could hear the marks. And then the poor guy, the German guy just before me, the music went out, and then I was delayed again. So it was really tough to get in the mold. But once again, I'm not competing against anybody else. It was against myself tonight. I won. I did a great job, and it feels good to be back.
Tracy Wilson said it's got to be a great feeling to know that you can just go on the ice and go for it.
Well, yeah, I don't have to worry about the injury because it's not a factor anymore. Pretty much I've gone out, did the warm-up, you know, 35, 40 minutes ago, come back almost cold, warm up a couple jumps and whip off the combination and the quad toe, and that means it's there.
Almost made Harbor Station an open-air theater. Congratulations. Good luck in the free.
Thank you.